Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. In this video, we will talk about the electronic oscillator and we will learn about the basic working principle of the oscillator. Now, the electronic oscillators are used in wide range of applications. They are used in laptop and smartphone processors for generating the clock signals, while they are used in the radio and mobile receivers for generating the local carrier frequency. And even they are used in the signal generators, which is used in the lab to test the circuits. So this oscillator accepts the DC voltage and it generates the periodic AC signal of the desired frequency. Now the oscillators can generate the frequencies from few hertz to even gigahertz. Now the output of the oscillator can be either a sinusoidal signal or a non-sinusoidal signal like a square wave and the triangular wave. Now in simple terms, this oscillator circuit is nothing but the amplifier which is given a positive feedback. So let us understand the working principle of this oscillator. So let's say some input sinusoidal signal is applied to this amplifier. So at the output, the input signal will get multiplied by the gain of this amplifier and the output signal will be equal to A times the input signal. Now let's say this output signal is given as an input to the feedback circuit. Now usually the feedback circuit used to be a frequency selective circuit or the resonant circuit. And let's say the output of this feedback circuit is equal to VF. So VF can be written as beta times output voltage. That is equal to A beta times input voltage. Where here this beta is nothing but the feedback fraction. And it defines what fraction of the output voltage is given as a feedback to the input stage. Now if the phase shift that is introduced by this amplifier in the feedback circuit is zero, in that case, this feedback signal will be in phase with the input signal. Now, let's say this feedback signal is getting added to the input signal and at the same time, the input signal is removed from the circuit. So now, this feedback signal VF will act as an input for this amplifier. So after removing the input voltage, whether we will get the sustained oscillations or not, that depends upon the product of this A and beta. And it is known as the loop gain of the oscillator. So if this loop gain A beta is less than 1, in that case, over the period of time, the input signal will die out. So now let's say in one particular circuit, A beta is equal to 0.9. And in this circuit, the input voltage Vin is equal to 2 volt of sine wave. So now whenever this input signal passes through this amplifier and the feedback circuit, then the input signal Vin will become 2 volt multiplied by the 0.9. That is equal to 1.8 volt. And once again, whenever this input signal passes through this loop, then the input signal will get reduced by the factor of 0.9. So in this way, every time this input signal passes through this loop, the amplitude of the input signal will reduce. And over the period of time, the oscillations in the circuit will die out. Similarly, whenever A beta is greater than 1, at that time, the oscillations in the circuit will build up. So as you can see, in both cases, we are not getting the sustained oscillations. And that is only possible whenever A beta is equal to 1. So when A beta is equal to 1, at that time, the feedback signal VF will be same as the input signal, provided the input signal and the feedback signal have a same phase. So in that case, we will get the sustained oscillations at the output. So in oscillator to get the sustained oscillations, two conditions should get satisfied. The first is, the product of this A beta should be equal to 1. And the second is the phase shift of this loop gain should be equal to 0. Meaning that whenever the input signal travels through this amplifier and the feedback circuit, the overall phase shift that is introduced by the circuit should be equal to 0. And these two criteria are known as the Barkhausen criteria for the oscillation. Now, so far we have assumed that whenever this oscillator is switched on, at that time, some finite amount of starting voltage is applied to this oscillator. But actually if you see, no signal is applied to this oscillator and still we are getting the oscillations at the output. So the question is, how is it possible? How we can get the oscillations at the output without giving any input to this oscillator? So the answer is, the thermal noise is present in every circuit. And if you are aware, this thermal noise contains all frequency components, starting from few hertz to even hundreds of gigahertz. So initially, whenever this oscillator is turned on, all the frequency components of this thermal noise will get amplified by the amplifier. And the amplified output of this thermal noise will be given as an input to the feedback circuit. Now, like I said earlier, this feedback circuit is the frequency selective circuit. So out of all the frequency components, only for one particular frequency, the phase shift that is introduced by this amplifier in the feedback circuit will be equal to 0, while all other frequencies will have a different phase. So from the all other frequencies, only one particular frequency will get added with the input noise. And in this oscillator circuit, initially the loop gain A beta is slightly set more than 1. And because of that, the noise signal of particular frequency will get built up over the period of time. And once the signal reaches certain voltage, at that time, the loop gain of this circuit will become 1. And it is possible because of the nonlinear behavior of the either amplifier or the feedback circuit. So in this way, the noise signal of the desired frequency will get built up over the period of time. And once the signal reaches finite voltage, then the loop gain of the circuit will become 1. And in this way, it is possible to get the sustained oscillations at the output. So this is the basic working principle of the oscillator. Now earlier, we had seen the two criteria for the sustained oscillations. And these two criteria can also be proved mathematically. So let's say the output of the feedback circuit is equal to Vf. And this signal Vf will get added with the input signal. So suppose if input signal is present, at that time, the input to the amplifier will be equal to Vin plus Vf. And at the output, we will get A times Vin plus Vf. Now here Vf is nothing but beta times output voltage. So if you put the value of this Vf, then Vout will be equal to A times Vin plus A beta times Vout. And if we simplify it, then we can say that Vout by Vin is equal to A divided by 1 minus A beta. Now here in the oscillator, we are not providing any sort of input signal and still we are getting the oscillations. It means that A beta in the circuit should be equal to 1, so that this condition will get fulfilled. So from this we can say that the magnitude of this loop gain should be equal to 1 and the phase shift that is introduced by this loop gain should be equal to 0. So in this way, mathematically, these two criteria can also be proved. Now, like I said before, in oscillators, the feedback circuit used to be a frequency selective circuit. So this feedback circuit can be made up of either RL, RC or RLC components. And even the quartz crystal can be used for the frequency selection. So depending upon the type of feedback circuit, the oscillator can be classified as either RC, LC or crystal oscillator. And moreover that, depending upon the arrangement of these components, these oscillators can be classified further. Now the oscillators which is mentioned over here are the sinusoidal oscillators, or even it is known as the harmonic oscillators, because the output of these oscillators used to be a sine wave. While some other oscillators also provide the different kind of shapes like square wave and the triangular wave. And these oscillators are known as the relaxation oscillators. And this type of relaxation oscillators can be built up using either op-amp or the timer ICs like 555 timer. And we will see the design of the different types of oscillators in the future videos. So I hope in this video, you understood the basic working principle of the oscillator. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.